Have you ever wondered how what you eat may be affecting your autoimmune disease? Are you curious about the foods that might trigger inflammation or aggravate your symptoms? If so, you are in the right place, because today I will explore the top foods that you should avoid if you suffer from an autoimmune disease. If you are eating these foods, they will make you more harm than you realize. So, if you suffer from lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, psoriatic arthritis, or another autoimmune disease, this information is crucial for you to manage your symptoms and live a better life.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
But before we jump into, please take a moment and make me a favor. Help me grow the audience of this channel. In the last few months, about 90% of people that watched, and there were more than 3.5 million views, did not subscribe, as probably you do not think about the YouTube algorithm. My target is to spread this useful and scientific-based information faster. So, make me a favor and click the subscribe button and help the YouTube algorithm, as more people will find this information faster. Thank you. Now, let's get started with the foods that you should cross off your shopping list. Processed foods and fast food. Processed foods and fast food are often loaded with artificial ingredients, unhealthy fats, and excessive salt. These foods will contribute to inflammation and worsen your symptoms of autoimmune diseases. It's best to avoid any processed snacks, sugary beverages, and deep-fried goodies that offer very little nutritional value. What I do recommend you is to skip that fast food this week and get a salad instead. Sugar. Sugar is another food that you should avoid. High sugar intake has been linked to increased inflammation in the body, which will worsen symptoms in people with autoimmune diseases. Not only that, but excessive sugar can lead to weight gain, increased risk of metabolic syndrome and type 2 diabetes, but will also increase your risk to develop an autoimmune disease like rheumatoid arthritis. Based on this study, if you drink soda every day, that will increase your risk to develop rheumatoid arthritis with 63%. So start cutting down from any sugar that you add to your coffee or any foods or drinks with added sugar. Replace that soda with plain or mineral water, or add a little bit of lemon to your water. Cut down from those cookies and desserts, and you will feel so much better with less pain, less stiffness, and less inflammation in your joints. Artificial sweeteners. Now, many of my patients will ask me, are artificial sweeteners better than real sugar? Artificial sweeteners commonly found in diet sodas or sugar-free products are not a good replacement of sugar. Why? Because artificial sweeteners like aspartame will disrupt gut health and will trigger more inflammation. They can also contribute to cravings for more sugar. So make sure you avoid aspartame or other artificial sweeteners if you suffer from an autoimmune disease. Salt. Who doesn't enjoy a meal that is more salty? We all know that salt can be a great preservative for foods, but will also enhance the taste. But is too much salt healthy? High sodium foods, such as processed meats, canned soups, and salty snacks can promote water retention and increase your blood pressure. But they can also increase inflammation levels and worsen your symptoms. There are many studies that show that excessive salt was linked to increase in the risk of developing autoimmune diseases. Now, let me give you an example. A study that was published in 2021 showed that people eating more than 3.5 grams of salt per day had an increased risk to develop rheumatoid arthritis, but also worsening the symptoms of people with rheumatoid arthritis with more pain and stiffness. So instead of eating processed food full of salt, try to opt out for fresh foods and season your meals with herbs and spices. Yes, use more spices like garlic, turmeric, and ginger to increase the flavor of your foods rather than adding more salt. Gluten. Can gluten worsen your autoimmune disease symptoms? Gluten, which is found in wheat, barley, and rye, can be problematic for some people, but not all. There are people with celiac disease and people with gluten sensitivity. For those people, gluten has been linked to more inflammation due to damage of the intestinal lining. In these people, eating gluten can trigger a strong immune response, which leads to damage in the small intestine lining. So, you can try to remove gluten from your diet and see if that will help your symptoms. You need to be consistent for at least 3 months to see if removing gluten is beneficial for you, as there is no laboratory test to prove that you are sensitive to gluten. If your symptoms improve, then continue to avoid gluten. If you see no difference, then resume your eating that includes foods with gluten. Now, to all my patients, I do recommend to avoid foods like white bread and white pasta. You could try these gluten-free alternatives like quinoa, rice, and gluten-free grains. If you suffer from rheumatoid arthritis, check out this video in my channel where I discuss about the top 10 foods that you should avoid and how to replace this. Dairy products. This is an ongoing debate. However, some people are sensitive to dairy. The proteins, casein, and lactose in dairy can potentially worsen symptoms like joint pain and digestive issues. Dairy products such as milk and mainly processed cheese can be inflammatory, and you may try to avoid them for some time and evaluate how you feel. However, I would still recommend to try plain yogurt, as it may bring you natural probiotics and it can help your gut. There are studies in people with rheumatoid arthritis that will support the use of probiotics to help decrease inflammation of the gut, like this study, where supplementing with a probiotic supplement for more than 8 weeks was helpful to decrease inflammation and improve the pain and stiffness. If dairy products are causing you more symptoms, you should consider exploring dairy-free alternatives like almond milk, coconut yogurt, or lactose-free options. Alcohol. When it comes to alcohol consumption, there is another debate. Generally speaking, small to moderate quantities of alcohol consumption can have good benefits for your health. However, the debate starts when we discuss about what is the limit that we should advise our patients about, as alcohol is one of the most abused and addictive drinks. There are studies that show that a small to moderate amount of alcohol, like less than 28 grams per day for men and less than 14 grams per day for females, can have a protective effect for developing autoimmune diseases like rheumatoid arthritis or lupus. However, that can depend on your body weight and genetics, as everyone is different in the way that they metabolize alcohol. There are studies like this one from 2010 that show that alcohol consumption has a beneficial effect in people with an increased risk for rheumatoid arthritis. So drinking alcohol can decrease the risk, but can also decrease the disease activity if you have rheumatoid arthritis with positive anti-CCP antibodies. It may also matter the type of alcohol that you drink, as wine looks better compared to hard liquor. This study suggests that drinking 3 times per week a glass of wine can be actually beneficial to decrease your risk to develop rheumatoid arthritis. But everyone is different, as I said, and I do not encourage you to drink. In fact, drinking a lot or excessive amounts or drinking every day can have negative impact on your gut, as it may destroy the gut lining and create more inflammation. So excessive alcohol can also disrupt sleep patterns, cause nutrient deficiency, and can interfere with some of the medications that you take. If you take methotrexate or leflunomide, these two types of medications are metabolized through your liver, and drinking alcohol can put you in great danger. So, when it comes to alcohol, moderation is the key. And it is very important to disclose to your doctor if you are drinking alcohol and be sincere about the amount of alcohol that you drink every day. Nightshade vegetables. Nightshade vegetables such as tomatoes, peppers, potatoes, and eggplants contain a compound called solanin, which may contribute to inflammation and joint pain in some people with autoimmune diseases. Maybe it's not for everyone, but I do encourage you to keep a food diary and write down how you feel after eating these type of foods. If you notice that you feel worse after eating white potatoes or eggplants, you should remove them from your table. There are studies that show that potatoes, especially when not well cooked or peeled, are high in solanin, this compound that has been associated with increased intestinal permeability, which can result in higher rheumatoid arthritis risk. Only through trial and elimination, you can see how you feel without these foods. Now, these are the top 8 foods that you should avoid if you suffer with an autoimmune disease. Remember, dietary changes should be individualized based on your specific needs and sometimes your sensitivities. It's important to listen to your body and make informed choices and consult with a specialized physician for personalized guidance. Through my company, Rheumatologist OnCall, I am able to help many patients across the United States to diagnose and treat autoimmune diseases. If you need help, don't hesitate to check out my website and, if needed, schedule an appointment from the comfort of your home. Leave me a comment in the section below, and if you find this video helpful, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and share it with others that might benefit from it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon.
RheumatologistOnCall.com